Hello, I'm Simen, the bass player of LEPROUS, and I want you to check out Loud TV. And I will love. If you're asking the routines right before we go on stage, that's very individual. So like Rafael, for example, our cello player, he loves to be like warm up maybe for 2 hours. I guess I asked him about this the other day, and he explained it has to do like with the nature of his instrument. Like he plays a stringed instrument, but it's not fretted, right? Like the bass and the guitars in LEPROUS, right? So he kind of has to have the tonal feel of his left hand just to be able to kind of, you know, intonate correctly and all that stuff. So that's his process. Like my process usually starts like an hour before the show. I get ready, I like put on my stage outfit, and then I just sit and warm up with my exercises. It's just using in my right hand, I tend to like warm up using a pick, because I'm playing with a pick for the most part in the show, during the show. And then I warm up using my fingers. But the interesting part for like Thor, he doesn't warm up at all. and he's a physiotherapist. So I was like, why doesn't he warm up? But he has his own process, and that's good. But I think it's good for like your muscles and ligaments and stuff to be a little bit warm before you start playing that actively. But I don't know, everybody's different. My point is, I heard on one TED talk one time that grit is like the key to success. Grit. And the thing that's defined as grit is just, it's like never giving up is a huge part of success. If you think about LEPROUS way before my time in the band, but it applies to me as an individual musician as well, I guess. Like, of course, there's been many times where I just want to take my bass and just break it in half and then use it as like firewood or something. Many, many, many times. But I guess like the internal motivation combined with like external, like, what do you call it, like affirmation, is very good drivers to just keep on going for a long time. And if you keep on going for a long time, like doors will open, and then you'll find new ways, but it will always develop in a direction you never expect. Like I joined LEPROUS like in 2015, late 14, 15, as a session player at first. And then I never thought in a million years I would be like a touring rock musician. That was not my way. I mean, I never wanted to be a rock musician, but here I am, like 5 years later, being a rock musician. I was out fixing something, and then I heard like the melody on below. And I remember how the notes were gliding from the one to the next, and I really liked the melody and the vibe of it and stuff. So I knew that was gonna be a good one. And Aina had already made like some vocal lines to it, and I could hear that this is gonna be great. So that was my favorite for a long time. I like to think of it like horizontal and vertical music. We can just talk, I will be uncomfortable mentioning other artists in my to describe my concept, but like, for example, this is only my subjective meaning or like thoughts, but the congregation is very, very linear. It's like it flows like this, if you know what I mean. It's very horizontal. And then Pitfalls has more of a vertical sound. You can kind of go into it. It has more dimensions. Personally, I prefer listening to music. If I'm as a music listener, when I really get into an album, I prefer music that's vertical versus linear. Like the congregation has a lot of cool ideas, and it's stretched out, like there's tons and tons of repetitions on the congregation riffs that goes like, you know, it's tons of repetitions. And I think that concept kind of was dragged out in the congregation. It was very like, yeah. But I really love diving into like vertical music. It's my thing. So I like it's Pitfalls, like personally, I prefer that to the congregation any day. But that's just me.
When I am far from home, I feel blurry.
I try to be very intuitive making the bass lines. A lot of stuff happened in the studio in a very short time. I was very lucky though, but I spent like 3+ days recording the whole album. All the songs we recorded. So I was very lucky with kind of the, I don't know, you mentioned preparations, right? So I prepared a few ideas and I knew what to keep open. I think this, I was lucky and it comes from experience. Like, okay, I need to check out this part because it requires me to master something technically, if you know what I mean. I need to know how to dub the guitars on this part just in case of that being required of me as a bass player. But sometimes I just kept a lot of the stuff open, so I just wrote down the chord, or wrote down the chords of every song, and then I just kind of played around with different scales, and I knew which kind of what kind of notes were in my grasp for all the ideas, and I tried different lines, but we didn't really choose anything until we were in the studio. So that's where everything happened. Pretty good. I mean, I've always written music. So for me, it's not like a big deal to write a piece of music, if you know what I mean. But it's like, it's cool to have that avenue open for me in LEPROUS. And because I'm a bass player, or a musician, I should say. I play like different instruments, but like bass as a main instrument. But it's a huge part of me to be creative. Like, and LEPROUS is taking up so much of my time. So if I can't use my creative input in LEPROUS, it will be hard, like long term, for me to be motivated to stay in a band. Yeah, if I can't write, so. Cool thing about Bård's role, because I've known Bård Kolstad for many years, and I've listened to him in as a player in different settings, like not only in LEPROUS or in Rendezvous Point or in like DJ and drums, because he's super expressive as a player, like and he
on his face.
Yeah. But like his playing style is like he's very much out there. He's trying to do, He's. I'm not saying he's like immature and trying to pour all his ideas. He's very mature in like not bringing more to the table that's actually needed. So he's very mature as a musician in that way. But still, I think it's kind of cool that people tend to play as they are as a person, if you know what I mean. He's very much out there. Very like, especially. He has two modes. He's like, either he's on or he's off. Like, and when he's on, it's like all over the place. And that kind of shines through in him as a musician, and I think that's kind of cool. But in LEPROUS, he kind of gets that crazy side out, so he couldn't be anywhere else, in my opinion. He could play in other bands, but you know, he needs to have that explosiveness and that outlet in his musicality. It's just my only my opinion, but so that's his role. And then that requires me to, he would probably argue, it would be very interesting to have a conversation with him regarding this, actually, because this is only my perspective. So you have to apologize if you're offended or something. But we're looking forward to all the festivals, of course, but like the spot on Hellfest this year is very good for us, so we're excited about that. I think so, yeah. We're gonna start to announce like more dates for new territories. This is our like our second European tour, second leg of Pitfalls tour, and then we're definitely working on some more dates in addition to like the festival dates that we've already announced. So nothing official, but you know, like we're aiming on doing like a world tour of the record. So and then we do have like a few surprises. I mean, like I made a few bass playthroughs I'm gonna release that I can say. But that's not like a huge deal, but we have like other stuff going on as well.